Howie, Mr. Howie Roseman. You let this man go in 2018. Didn't make the roster. I get it. He wasn't the player that he is now. But you and Sean Desai, I think that y'all can definitely bring this man on. And we need him. And it'll make you say, CJ who? Trying to tell you. One more thing. I love what Howie's saying about Jordan Davis. But Jordan Davis is definitely going to have to prove it. This is a prove a year for him. Let's talk about it, y'all. Yo, that.
A-G-L-E-S.
Eagles!
Eagles! Say fly, Eagles, fly.
Fly, Eagles, fly. Fly, Eagles, fly.
Yo, that man, you know who it is, you know what it is, your boy Philly Fresh, aka the General here, reporting for duty. Listen, if you have not done it, make sure you hit that sub button that's right down there it go. Yes, and also, it's a bell that's here to let you know when I put up all this flavor, notification gang, yo that gang, yo that. Please, y'all been doing a great job for your boy. Make sure you hit the like, however the algorithm works, more people get to see me, more people get to see the merch, man. You know, shout out to Print Champs. We finally got that link in there. So make sure it will be in the description. Bet us is the best bet in that, man. Shout out to Bet Us. I know they got DraftKings and you got all these other situations out there, but Bet Us is the only app that is going to give you 125% down on your first deposit. You put down 100, you got 225. In your account. All right. Fresh fact today is, man. A lot of things may not go your way, but all it takes is that one thing, and you could be a happy person. So don't give up. Whatever your situation is, a job, doing this, you know what I mean? Anything, man. It could be that one video that blow you up. It could be that one good thing you do to turn your whole life around. So just don't give up, man. That's all I got to say. All right. Mr. Howie Roseman. Mr. Sean Desai. I think that you can make a real pitch at Ryan Neal. I think that you can make a hell of a pitch at Ryan Neal. A lot of people think that we're broke, but I think we're seventh in cap. And I don't think it's really about the money with this kid. Like I said, we had him in 2018. In 2018, he was an undrafted free agent. Came to the Philadelphia Eagles to try out, and he didn't make the team. But now, how the tables have turned. I mean, you need a guy like this. Losing C.J. Gardner-Johnson, you get Ryan Neal, who has instincts. And knows how to play, how to shift his body, how to bait quarterbacks. I mean, this is and the Seahawks let him go. They let him go. Maybe they feel as though they got somebody better. I don't know. But I like this kid a lot. I mean, when you look at what he did last year, what we got here? He only played 14 games. 63 tackles. 42 of them was solo, 21 assisted, obviously. He had one sack, one interception, and he had 8 pass deflections. That's pretty good. That's pretty good for him. Like, to me, you get home, you say C.J. Gardner who? You say C.J. Gardner who? Now, we know C.J. Gardner-Johnson's ceiling might be higher than what Ryan Neal is bringing, but Ryan Neal can get the job done. And this is what you need, especially when you don't know. Like, I like Reed Blankenship. I do. But I don't know how he's going to perform in a whole season. We know what this guy's going to do in a whole season. Be solid. Guys can have a good couple games, and then people start looking at their tactics and knowing their tactics and know how to play off of what they're doing. And then you get exposed. That's why You got people, some people that come into the league, they tear the league up for the first couple weeks. Look at Lin Sanity. Remember that? Jeremy Lin came and tearing the league up till he faced Patrick Beverley. Till he faced Patrick Beverley and he had a donut. These things can happen, man. Go get this guy. All right, so we're going to look at what Howie Roseman had to say about Jordan Davis. And I'm going to respond, y'all.
10 years ago would have been a top three pick.
I agree.
And so you're going through it and you're going, why is this guy falling, yeah, right? And everyone's going, well, he only played 40% of the time at Georgia, you know? Mm-hmm. The guy won the Lombardi and the Outland Trophy. He was top 10 in the Heisman Trophy, mm-hmm, with the best defense in the country that won the national championship game. Yeah. And so you're going, what are we missing? A freak show athlete.
Freak.
What do we miss? Good character? Yeah, he was freaking captain of Georgia. I mean, I was, mm-hmm, with someone yesterday who said, unbelievable leader. One of the games we lost this year, who was at the front of the locker room greeting everyone?
Yeah, yeah. Georgia. He's got an unbelievable personality.
Yeah, unbelievable personality. Yeah. And so you're going, what is going on here? And it's like, well, he can't play on third down.
Why? Yeah.
I mean,
he
that
runs
guy's got
4.7 and he's 360.
That guy's got a head of steam. Yeah. How are you stopping that guy, you know? And so it's like, that to me was a situation where it's like, all right, why is he playing 40 or 50% of the plays? Well, really look at the games that, mm-hmm, Georgia was in last year. They were winning 42-7 in the third quarter, most of those games. And then they're smart. They have all these five-star recruits.
Well, that's
going,
the other area.
We got to keep these guys here.
We have all these unbelievable players. We need to utilize all of them so that everybody's happy and it's a good team environment.
So we don't lose them a year from now when Jordan leaves.
If he's on another team, I guarantee he's playing on third down and rushing the passer.
And in the close games, in the national championship games, he's playing 60% of the plays.
Right.
And so for...
What do you have? Howie Roseman, he's definitely right, though. Not going to lie to you. When he breaks down the numbers, he's a number guy. And it makes you say, this is why... Howie is so good at talking. This is why he gets the good deals. He just probably made everybody watching the video say, damn, you know what? Them numbers, the way he break down them numbers, that sounds right. And it kind of does. You know what I mean? I get what he's saying. I understand it. But we got to talk about this year. He's going to have the opportunity to play 60% of those snaps. Probably more. And we're going to need some productivity. I mean, when you look at it, I get it. He played 13 games last year. I want to say he only played probably like 40% of the snaps. But it wasn't an impact. It wasn't a game that I said Jordan Davis shut everything down. I mean, when you look at it, he had 18 sacks, 8 solo. He had one pass deflection. No forced fumbles, no quarterback hits, no sacks. So this is your year. This is your year, big guy. No Hargrave. No Milton. I mean, Milton Williams is still there, but we lost somebody else. I can't remember his name. But no Hargrave. To me, Milton Williams is probably going to start, but that should be you. You should come into camp at... Well, you was 360, but then you dropped to 340, 335. At 335, 340, and come dominate the camp. You should dominate preseason. And we're going to see. I love Jordan Davis. I love the pick. A lot of people question him not being able to get after the quarterback, or he can't play on third down, yada, yada, yada. He has to answer those questions. We can talk as much as we want. We can scream to the hills, Jordan Davis, Jordan Davis. He has to be accountable, and he has to answer those questions. And he does that by going on the field and balling out. Now, sometimes the stats, when it comes to a DT, the stats is not going to show how productive he is. But you still have to understand that there still has to be a level of dominance when you see and you turn on the tape, or you turn on the game and said, he shut that down. That's what we need from you, big dog. Let me know what y'all think in the comments. Y'all already know, man. Stay Philly. Stay fresh, y'all. Yo, that.